Now, 2 years ago, the UK's embassy in Tel Aviv became the first to set up a technology hub. It's aimed at getting British companies to partner with the best in Israeli innovation and help boost economic growth. Now, for more on this, we're joined by our Middle East editor, Elliott Gotkine. Elliott.
Francine, as you say, this was the first of its kind by an embassy, and it's now celebrating its second birthday. And here to join the celebrations, we've got the CEO of Tech City UK and the UK's digital ambassador, Joanna Shields. Joanna, thanks very much for joining us today. Your main focus is, of course, in London, but also bridging, I suppose, London to other technology centres. You're here in Tel Aviv, often described as one of the leading innovation centres in the world, perhaps the second after Silicon Valley. How do you compare London with Tel Aviv?
Well, there's an entrepreneurial movement happening in London as well. I think with the tough economic times, people have looked to entrepreneurship as a credible path to success. So lots of new ideas happening. In the UK, we have East London's Tech City, and we have over 1,500 digital businesses growing there, but also 13 other clusters across the country that are thriving around universities and some of our metropolitan areas. So it's a great time to connect Israel and the startup scene here with what's happening in the UK.
And the UK Israel Tech Hub at the British Embassy, what has it actually achieved in its 2 years in terms of partnering UK companies with Israeli ones, getting Israeli technology in the UK and perhaps vice versa?
Well, I think we all think about the internet successes and, you know, the internet economy, which is the fastest growing segment of the British economy. So we think about that first when we think about Tel Aviv and London, for instance. But it's across all sectors. So it goes from clean tech to biomedicine to material science to even energy and gas. So the connections that are being made between, you know, Israel and the UK across all sectors, which is really exciting.
And what for you is your kind of your biggest achievement so far in terms of this, I suppose, groundbreaking tech hub for the UK embassy?
Well, I think the biggest achievement lies ahead. We've launched a new segment on the London Stock Exchange called the High Growth Segment, and we are here on a mission to find the 50 fastest growing companies that we can actually encourage to look at London as an IPO potential, as a listing market. Here in Israel, companies always go for New York. It's a natural progression for Israel startups to move to the U.S., either in New York or Silicon Valley. Well, London's become a credible alternative. We've had a recent success with Plus 500 in the UK, which is Israeli founders from the Technion doing great things around the financial technology space. We've got some word in the press today about some potential ad tech companies here that might be looking for a London listing. So we think that's going to be a great opportunity for Israeli companies in the future.
Okay, yeah, we understand that Matomi, which has a mobile advertising platform, is probably going to list in London probably the beginning of next year. In terms of comparing, how likely is it for London, for Britain, to emulate the success of Israel in terms of startups? I mean, I was looking at the figures on the OECD. Israel invests more in research and development than any other country, about three times more as a percentage of its overall economy than the UK. Is that something that's perhaps holding the UK back?
Well, I think what you're seeing now is our great universities in the UK are investing in startup hubs and creating, you know, accelerators and incubators before people even leave university. You know, in the US, the strength has always been, and also in Israel, people start to think about the business they'll create before they even leave university. Well, that's starting to happen in the UK as well. So we have 13 tech clusters around the country based around our great universities, and we're emulating the US and Israel, but also focused on the core strengths of the economies in which those clusters are operating. Okay. So, you know, in Bristol, you have a very strong tech cluster around the university and biomedicine, and in other, you know, in London, you have the universities in the, around the internet and e-commerce sector.
Okay, just very, very quickly, Twitter IPO coming soon. Said it's going to be worth more than $12 billion. Is it a fad? Is it worth it?
I think Twitter is a very strong story for advertisers.
Okay.
The real-time nature of it just delivers great results.
Okay, and the real-time nature of TV always great as well. Joanna Shields, UK Tech Digital Envoy and Head of Tech City UK. Thanks for joining us today. Francine, I'll hand it back to you.
Guys, thank you so much. That was a great interview. Our Elliott Gotkine.